Good morning everyone. Today we are going to look at the two models of semiotics. So let's just start with the video. Starting with the semiotics, the first question is, what is semiotics? So semiotics is the study of signs. If we look at in a very simple words. Okay, now we have phonemes in the spoken language as the basic unit of sounds. Now we have sharams or sharims in sign language. These are also very small units in sign language, that is sharims or sharams. Now there are two approaches or two models in semiotics that we are going to do, and these two models are dyadic model of signs and the other one is triadic model of signs. So let's just look at them one by one. Let's just first look at the dyadic model of signs. So dyadic model of sign was given by Ferdinand de Saussure. According to him, every sign has two parts, and he named these parts as signifier and the other as signified. And signifier means the form, that is form of word, and signified as the mental concept it arises. Okay, so we have the form or the word as the tree, and we have the image of the tree, the mental concept that comes, that is the image of the tree or the real object tree, but they do not hold any one-to-one relationship between each other. Means, why do we call that tree a tree? We do not have any such relation, okay, one-to-one correspondence, but they are used for so many years, that's why they have become a convention. So this relationship is known as arbitrary relationship. So this is all for the dyadic relation of sign. Now let's just look at the triadic model of signs. Now the second model is the triadic model. Triadic model was given by Pierce, and he said that every sign has three parts, and these three parts were icons, index and symbols. Now the difference, we will look at the difference between these three. First is icon. So icon is something that physically represents what it stands for. For example, we have the icon of printer in our computers, and that icon of a printer represents the print function or represent the printer which is present in the outside world. Now let's come to index. If we look at the index, there is no physical representation that is present in the outside world. Rather, it denotes its object by virtue of an actual connection involving them. For example, we have the image of the skull. So skull indices danger. There is no skull which is present. There is no danger which is present in the outside world. So this is skull represents something else, and that is danger. So it is index. Now coming to the third one, and the third one is symbols. Symbols basically do not have such relations as icons or index have, but rather their relations are arbitrary in nature. Means there is no one-to-one correspondence between them, between the word and between the mental concept it represents. For example, we have the word pen, and it represents the word pen, but why do we call a pen a pen? There is no relation between them. That relation is arbitrary in nature. So this is all for the triadic model of signs. That's all on the part of semiotics. Thank you so much.